Welcome to Science and Technology part of Current Affairs. In this video, we are going to see about the space technologies. First one, Gaganyaan mission. It is an Indian crewed orbital spacecraft intended to be the formative spacecraft of the Indian human spaceflight program. It is designed to carry 3 astronauts to space. Crew vehicle is planned to be launched on ISRO's GSLV Mark 3. GSLV Mk 3. ISRO aims to launch Gaganyaan before the 75th anniversary of India's independence in 2022. DRDO will provide support for critical human-centric systems and technologies like space-grade food, crew healthcare, radiation measurement and protection, parachutes for the safe recovery of the crew module, and fire suppression system. ISRO's Human Space Flight Center and Glavkosmos, which is a subsidiary of Russian state corporation Roscosmos, signed an agreement on 2019 for cooperation in the selection, support, medical examination and space training of Indian astronauts. ISRO will receive assistance from the French space agency CNES in terms of expertise, various fields including space medicine, astronaut health monitoring, radiation protection and life support, etc. On January 22nd, 2020, ISRO announced Vyom Mitra, a female robot who will accompany other astronauts in the mission. A new center, namely Human Space Flight Center, is created within ISRO DOS with the responsibility to act as the lead center for human space flight program Gaganyaan. A Gaganyaan National Advisory Council has been created with members from different institutions and industries. Gaganyaan Advisory Council comprises of secretaries of Department of Space, Department of Science and Technology, DRDO, Department of Science and Technology and Science and Scientific and Industrial Research, Principal Scientific Advisor to PM, Senior Officials of Armed Forces, Indian Coast Guard, former Chairman of ISRO, Member of Space Commission, former Director of Aeronautical Development Agency, former Indian Astronaut, Directors of Premier Academic and Research Institutions and Heads of various Indian industries. It discusses overall project status of Gaganyaan, covering technical details as well as collaboration with various national stakeholders. So important points, Gaganyaan mission is an Indian crewed orbital spacecraft, formative spacecraft for Indian human space flight program. Crew vehicle planned to be launched on ISRO's GSLV Mark 3, and ISRO aims to launch Gaganyaan before the 75th anniversary of Indian independence. DRDO will provide critical human-centric systems and technologies. ISRO's Human Space Flight Center and Glavkosmos signed an agreement for the cooperation in the selection, support, medical examination and space training of Indian astronauts. French space agency CNES also has a hand on it. And Vyom Mitra, a female robot who will accompany other astronauts in the mission. Human Space Flight Center has been created. Gaganyaan National Advisory Council with various members from various departments and institutions has been included in this council. That council discusses overall project status of Gaganyaan. So next topic, Vyom Mitra. It is ISRO's first woman astronaut. It is a female space-faring humanoid robot developed by the ISRO to function on board the Gaganyaan, which is a crewed orbital spacecraft. Vyom Mitra, equipped with a head, 2 arms and a torso, and it is built to mimic crew activity inside the crew module of Gaganyaan. Functions of Vyom Mitra: attending launch and orbital posters, responding to the environment, generating warnings, replacing carbon dioxide canisters, operating switches, monitoring the crew module, receiving voice commands, responding via speech. It is bilingual. So important points, Vyom Mitra is ISRO's first woman astronaut. It is a female space-faring humanoid robot developed by ISRO on board Gaganyaan. It is built to mimic crew activity inside the crew module of Gaganyaan. Responding via speech, it is bilingual. Next topic, Navigation in Indian constellation. Qualcomm Technologies has unveiled mobile chipsets supporting the Indian Regional Satellite Navigation System. That is NAVIC. Navigation in Indian constellation. The expansion of NAVIC is Navigation in Indian constellation. The release of chipsets will help accelerate the adoption of NAVIC by smartphone original equipment manufacturers. Global standard body third generation partnership projects. Third generation partnership project, which develops protocols for mobile telephony, has approved India's regional navigation system, NAVIC. The specification approval will boost commercial use of NAVIC by international and domestic mobile device markers, mobile device makers. Acceptance of NAVIC by third generation partnership project would also bring NAVIC technology to the commercial market for its use in 4G, 5G and Internet of Things. 3GPP, that is third generation partnership project, comprises seven telecommunication standard development organizations: ARIB, ATIS, CCSA, ETC, TSDSI, TTA, TTC, from across the world, and provides their members with a stable environment to produce specifications that define 3GPP technologies. 3GPP currently has global navigation satellite system support from BDS of Chinese, Galileo from European, GLONASS from Russian, and GPS of US for cellular positioning system. US Congress has consented to the designate India's NAVIC as its allied navigational satellite system, along with the Galileo of European Union and QZSS of Japan. The designation of India's NAVIC as an allied system is part of the American effort to develop a prototype program for multi-global navigation system, multi-global navigation satellite system, that is GNSS receiver development. US also designates Russia's GLONASS and Chinese Beidou as a non-allied system. It means that the US satellite navigation system will not cooperate or exchange data with these two satellite navigation systems. US also designates Russia's GLONASS and Chinese Beidou as non-allied system. So what is NAVIC? The Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, IRNSS, with an operational name of NAVIC, is an independent regional navigation satellite. The position information, it is designed to provide position information in the Indian region and 15 km around the Indian mainland. Services provided. It would provide two types of services. One, standard positioning service available to all users, and restricted service, which is an encrypted one provided to authorized users, including the military. NAVIC-based vehicle tracker system has been made compulsory to all commercial vehicles. Its applications include terrestrial, aerial, and marine navigation, disaster management, vehicle trafficking, vehicle tracking and fleet management, integration with mobile phones, precise timing, mapping and geodetic data capture, terrestrial navigation aid for hikers and travelers, visual and voice navigation for drivers. So it's been involved in various applications. How many satellites does NAVIC consist of? It consists of seven satellites. Three of these will be geostationary over the Indian Ocean. That is, they will appear to be stationary in the sky over the region. And four will be geosynchronous. Three geostationary, four geosynchronous. The geosynchronous appears at the same point in the sky at the same time every day. Two additional satellites on ground as standby. So this configuration ensures each satellite is being tracked by at least one of 14 ground stations at any given point of time, with a high chance of most of them being visible from any point in India. So why it is necessary to have indigenous global navigation system? Having a global navigation system, it bolsters the ability of a nation to serve as a net security provider, especially through the guarantee of such assurance policies. It can also play a significant role in relief efforts post-disasters such as tsunami in the Indian Ocean region in 2004 and Pakistan-India earthquake in 2005. So what are all the important topics of important points of NAVIC? It is an Indian region satellite navigation system. NAVIC means navigation in Indian constellation. Global standards body, third generation partnership project, develops protocol for mobile telephony, has approved India's regional navigation system, NAVIC. Navigation in Indian constellation has been approved by US Congress as its allied navigational system, along with Galileo of European and QSSS of Japan. The designation of India's NAVIC as an allied system is part of the American effort to develop a prototype program for multi-global navigation satellite system, that is GNSS receiver development. So NAVIC is Indian Regional Navigation System with an operational name of NAVIC, and it is an independent regional navigation satellite in order to provide position information in the Indian region and 1,500 kilometers around the Indian mainland. It provides two types of services: standard positioning services available to all users, and restricted services, which is an encrypted one provided to authorized users, including the military. So there are seven satellites in NAVIC: 3 geostationary, 4 geosynchronous. This configuration ensures each satellite is being tracked by at least one of the 14 ground stations at any given point of time. Next topic, Chandrayaan 2 mission. Chandrayaan 2 is a second lunar exploration mission developed by ISRO after Chandrayaan 1. It currently consists of lunar orbiter and also include Vikram lander and Pragyan lunar rover, all of which were developed in India. Lunar orbiter and also included Vikram lander and Pragyan lunar rover, all of which are developed in India. The main scientific objective is to map and study the variations in lunar surface composition as well as the location and abundance of lunar water. The spacecraft was launched on its mission to the moon from the second launch pad at Satish Dhawan Space Center on 22nd July 2019 by a GSLV Mark 3 rocket. The craft reached the moon's orbit on 20th August 2019 and began orbital positioning maneuvers for the landing of Vikram lander. Vikram and the rover were scheduled to land on the near side of the moon in the South Polar region on 6 September 2019. A successful soft landing would have made India the fourth country after USSR, US and PRC to do so. But however, the lander deviated from its intended trajectory and had lost communication when touchdown confirmation was expected. ISRO may re-attempt a soft landing with Chandrayaan 3. Goals and primary objectives of mission. Primary objective of Chandrayaan 2 was to demonstrate the ability to soft land on the lunar surface, that is in the lunar south pole, and operate a robotic rover on the surface. Scientific goals included studies of lunar topography, mineralogy, elemental abundance, lunar exosphere, and signatures of hydroxyl and water ice. Other objectives: it is to find out the minerals and indicators of hydroxyl and water molecules, to study the surface of moon, to study the density of the electrons in the moon's ionosphere, that is the uppermost part of atmosphere that is ionized by radiation. The orbiter will observe the lunar surface and relay communication between Earth and Chandrayaan's lander. Why is the study of moon important? Moon is the closest celestial body at which space discovery can be attempted and documented to trace back the origin and evolution of moon. Why the South Pole has been targeted? The South Polar region of the moon has not received sunlight for billions of years and is among the coldest spots in the solar system. This makes lunar South Pole region ripe to contain tons of water and an undisturbed record of solar system's origin. This makes lunar South Pole region ripe to contain tons of water and an undisturbed record of the solar system's origins. And Chandrayaan 1. Chandrayaan 1 was developed by India in October 2009 using PSLV C-11. Scientists have found frozen water deposits in the darkest and coldest parts of the moon's polar regions using data from the Chandrayaan 1 spacecraft. ISRO lost communication with Chandrayaan 1 on 2009, barely a year after it was launched on October 2008. It was launched in 2008 and lost communication in 2009. Chandrayaan 1 mission performed high resolution remote sensing of the moon in visible near infrared, low energy X-rays and high energy X-ray regions. One of the objectives was to prepare a three-dimensional atlas with high spatial and altitude resolution of both near and far side of the moon. It aimed at conducting chemical and mineralogical mapping of the entire lunar surface for distribution of mineral and chemical elements such as magnesium, aluminium, silicon, calcium, iron, titanium, as well as high atomic number elements such as radon, uranium and thorium with high spatial resolution. Then Chandrayaan 3. Chandrayaan 3 is a planned third lunar exploration mission by ISRO. Chandrayaan 3 will be a mission repeat of Chandrayaan 2 and will only include a lander and a rover similar to that of Chandrayaan 2 and will not have an orbiter. It will only have a lander and a rover. It will not have an orbiter. Next topic, Indian data relay system, data relay satellite system. India plans to ring in its own era of space-to-space tracking and communication of its space assets by putting up a new satellite series called Indian Data Relay Satellite System. So what is it? IDRSS, Indian Data Relay Satellite System, is planned to track and be constantly in touch with Indian satellites, in particular those in low Earth orbits which have limited coverage of Earth. It will be a set of satellites that will track, send and receive information from other Indian satellites. IDRSS satellites of the 2000 kilogram class would be launched on the GSLV launcher to geostationary orbits around 36,000 kilometers away. A satellite in the GEO covers a third of the Earth below, and three of them can provide total coverage. What is the significance? It will be vital to the ISRO, whose roadmap is dotted with advanced LEO missions such as space docking, space station, as well as distant expeditions to Moon, Mars and Venus. It will also be useful in monitoring launches. The first beneficiary would be the prospective crew members of Gaganyaan mission of 2022, who can be fully and continuously in touch with the mission control throughout their travel. Next topic, GSAT-30. First mission of ISRO in 2020. India's telecommunication satellite GSAT was successfully launched, and it is the first mission of ISRO in 2020. The launch took place from the spaceport in French Guiana. The launch vehicle is named Ariane 5 VA-251. What are the key facts? GSAT-30 derives its heritage from ISRO's earlier INSAT and GSAT satellite series and will replace INSAT-4A in orbit. It is configured on ISRO's enhanced I3K bus structure to provide communication services from geostationary orbit. GSAT-30 uses two satellite frequencies. It gives the Indian mainland and island coverage in the Q band. It gives the Indian mainland and islands coverage in the Q band and extended coverage in a wide area stretching from Australia to Europe in the lower frequency C band. Indian mainland and island coverage in the Q band and Australia to Europe in the lower frequency C band. The Q and C bands are part of the spectrum of frequencies ranging from 1 to 40 gigahertz that are used in satellite communications. Services. With a mission life of 15 years, GSAT-30 will provide DTH, that is direct-to-home television services, connectivity to VSAT, that is very small aperture terminals for ATMs, stock exchange, television uplinking and teleport services, digital satellite news gathering and e-governance applications. So what is Ariane Space? It is the world's first commercial launch service provider. And since the launch of India's Apple experimental satellite on Ariane Flight LO3 in 1981, Ariane Space has orbited 24 satellites, including GSAT, for the Indian Space Agency. Next topic, RISAT 2BR1, India's polar satellite launch vehicle, in its 50th flight, that is PSLV C-48, has successfully launched RISAT 2BR1 along with 9 commercial satellites from Satish Dhawan Center in Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. This is PSLV's 50th successful mission and the 75th launch vehicle mission from Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota. PSLV's 50th successful mission and 75th launch vehicle mission from Satish Dhawan Space Center. So what is RISAT 2BR1? It is a radar imaging Earth observation satellite. It provides services in the field of agriculture, forestry and disaster management. Its mission life is 5 years. What is PSLV? Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle is an indigenously developed expendable launch system of ISRO. It comes in the category of medium lift launchers with a reach up to various orbits, including the geosynchronous transfer orbit, lower Earth orbit, and polar sun synchronous orbit. Differences between PSLV and GSLV. India has two operational launchers, PSLV and GSLV. GSLV was developed to launch the heavier inset class of geosynchronous satellites into orbit. GSLV was developed to launch heavier inset class of geosynchronous satellites into the orbit. Different orbits, three main types of orbits, high Earth orbit, medium Earth orbit and low Earth orbit. Which orbit a particular satellite is placed is depend on its function. When satellites are about 36,000 km from the Earth's surface, they enter what is called the high Earth orbit. Here, its orbit in sync with the Earth's rotation, creating the impression that the satellite is stationary over a single longitude. Such a satellite is said to be geosynchronous. Just as the geosynchronous satellites have a sweet spot over the equator that allows them to stay over one spot on Earth, polar orbiting satellites have a sweet spot that allows them to stay in one time. Geosynchronous sweet spot on Earth that allows them to stay over one spot on Earth. Polar orbiting satellites allows them to stay in one time. This orbit is sun synchronous orbit. One spot is geosynchronous, one time is sun synchronous, which means that whenever and wherever the satellite crosses the equator, the local solar time on the ground is always the same. PSLV, next topic, PSLV C-47. India's polar satellite launch vehicle, PSLV C-47, has launched Cartosat 3 and 13 commercial nano satellites into sun synchronous orbit from Satish Dhawan Space Center. So what is Cartosat 3? It is a third generation agile advanced Earth observation satellite. Cartosat 3 is an Earth observation satellite with high resolution imaging capability. Developed by ISRO, it will replace the IRS series. Applications. Cartosat 3 could be potentially used for weather mapping and cartography. It aims to address the increased demands for large-scale urban planning, rural resource and infrastructure development, coastal land use and land cover. Next topic, GeoTile. It is an instrument on Chandrayaan 2, that is class Chandrayaan 2 Large Area Soft X-ray Spectrometry. An instrument on Chandrayaan 2, which is called as class Chandrayaan 2 Large Area Soft X-ray Spectrometer, designed to detect signatures of elements in the moon's soil and had detected charged particles during the mission. What is GeoTile? A region in space that allows the best observations. GeoTile is a region in space that allows the best observations. The region exists as a result of the interaction between the sun and the earth. How is it formed? The sun emits solar wind, which is a continuous stream of charged particles. These particles are embedded in the extended magnetic field of the sun. Since the earth has a magnetic field, it obstructs the solar wind plasma. These interactions result in the formation of a magnetic envelope around the Earth. On the Earth side facing the Sun, the envelope is compressed into a region that is approximately 3 to 4 times the Earth's radius. On the opposite side, the envelope is stretched into a long tail which extends beyond the orbit of the Moon. So it is this tail that is called the GeoTile. Once every 29 days, the Moon traverses the GeoTile for about 6 days. Next topic, East Asian Observation Consortium. India is in preliminary discussion to be a part of the East Asian Observatories Consortium of 8 countries committed to build large telescopes and pool resources. What is East Asian Observatory? It is formed by East Asian Core Observatories Association for the purpose of pursuing joint projects in astronomy within the East Asian region. The intention of EAO is to build and operate facilities which will enhance and leverage the existing and planned regional facilities. It will also raise funding and to build an observatory staff separate from that of the ESEAO institutions. The EAO is chartered as a non-profit Hawaii corporation. Its first task is to assume the operation of the James Clerk Maxwell Submillimeter Telescope on the summit of Mauna Kea, Hawaii. It consists of China, Japan, Taiwan, Korea as full members. And Thailand, Vietnam, Malaysia and Indonesia as observers. So it is important. So who are all the members of East Asian Observatory? China, Japan, China, Taiwan, Japan, Korea as full members. Thailand, Vietnam, Malaysia and Indonesia as observers. Implications for India. Having India join the group could mean the establishment of new kinds of telescopes. That is the one proposed to be being in the Tibet that could aid the observation of new black holes and throw light on cosmic phenomena. Next topic. NASA's Voyager 2 spacecraft. NASA has managed to fix its Voyager 2 probe remotely, almost 11.5 billion miles away from its location. Accomplishments so far. Voyager 2 is the only probe ever to study Neptune and Uranus during planetary flybys. It is the second man-made object to leave the heliosphere. Voyager 2 is the only spacecraft to have visited all four gas giant planets, that is Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and discovered 16 moons as well as the phenomenon like Neptune's mysteriously transient great dark spot. The cracks in Europa's ice shell and ring features at every planet. The important points. Voyager 2 by NASA. Voyager 2 is the only probe ever to study Neptune and Uranus during planetary flybys. Second man-made object to leave the heliosphere. Voyager 2 is the only spacecraft to have visited all four gas giant planets. And it studied the phenomenon of great dark spot of Neptune, cracks in Europa's ice shell, and ring features of every planet. What is interstellar space? Scientists use the heliopause to mark where interstellar space begins. Although, depending on how you define your solar system, it can stretch all the way to the Oort cloud, which begins 1,000 times farther away from the Sun and Sun than Earth's orbit. So, important points: Oort cloud begins 1,000 times farther away from the Sun than the Earth's orbit. Heliopause marks where the interstellar space begins. What is heliosphere? Heliosphere is a bubble around the Sun created by the outward flow of solar wind from the Sun and opposing inward flow of interstellar wind. Heliosphere is a bubble around the Sun created by the outward flow of the solar wind from the Sun and the opposing inward flow of the interstellar wind. The heliosphere is a region influenced by the dynamic properties of the Sun that are carried in the solar wind, such as magnetic field, energetic particles and solar wind plasma. The heliopause marks the end of the heliosphere and the beginning of the interstellar space. About Voyager mission. Launched in 1970s, and the probes sent by NASA were only meant to explore the outer planets, but they just kept on going. Voyager 1 departed Earth on 1977, a few days after Voyager 2, and left our solar system in 2013, that is in the September of 2013. Voyager 1 on 1977 and Voyager 2 on 2013. The mission objective of the Voyager interstellar mission is to extend the NASA's exploration of the solar system beyond the neighborhood of the outer planets to the outer limits of the Sun's sphere of influence and possibly beyond that influence. The Voyager spacecraft are the third and fourth human spacecraft to fly beyond all the planets in our solar system. Next topic, Solar Orbiter Mission. The mission is a collaboration between ESA and NASA, European Space Agency and NASA. It was launched from Cape Canaveral on United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket. So what is that Solar Orbiter? It is a mission dedicated to solar and heliospheric physics. It was selected as the first medium-class mission of ESA's Cosmic Vision 2015 to 2025 program. This is the first mission that will provide images of the Sun's north and south poles. It is a 7-year mission. It has a custom titanium heat shield coated in calcium phosphate. So that it can endure temperatures up to 970 degree Fahrenheit. Objectives: to examine how the Sun creates and controls the heliosphere, to gain new information about the solar wind, the heliospheric magnetic field, transitory interplanetary disturbances and sun's magnetic field. Solar Orbiter will set about answering the four top-level science questions. 1. What drives the solar wind and where does the coronal magnetic field originate from? How do solar transients drive heliospheric variability? How do solar eruptions produce energetic particle radiations that fills the heliosphere? How does the solar dynamic work and drive connections between the sun and the heliosphere? So these are the four questions the solar orbiter tries to find the answer. Significance. Understanding the sun's magnetic field and solar wind are key because they contribute to the space weather. The mission will work in tandem with NASA's Parker Solar Probe, which is currently orbiting the sun on a 7-year mission. Background. Solar Orbiter follows the ULISA spacecraft, another collaboration between ULISA spacecraft, another collaboration between ESA and NASA. It was launched in 1990. Next topic, Very Large Telescope. Using the European Space Organization's Very Large Telescope, astronomers noticed an unprecedented dimming of Betelgeuse, a red supergiant star, which is over 20 times bigger than the sun, in the constellation Orion. European Space Organization's Very Large Telescope noticed the dimming of Betelgeuse. Betelgeuse is a red supergiant star in the constellation Orion. Along with the dimming, the star's shape has been changing as well. So what is VLT? It is the world's most advanced optical system. The telescope can work together to form a giant interferometer, the ESO, Very Large Telescope Interferometer. Allowing astronomers to see details up to 25 times finer than with the individual telescopes. Location in Atacama Desert, northern Chile. VLT consists of four individual telescopes. Four separate optical telescopes are known as ANTU, QAN, Melipal, UPAN, which are all words of astronomical objects in the Mapuche language. VLT operates at visible and infrared wavelength. Important points are, VLT is the world's most advanced optical instrument with main mirrors 8.2 meter diameter and four movable 1.8 meter diameter auxiliary telescopes VLT consists of four individual telescopes. Four separate optical telescopes are known as ANTU, QAN, Melipal and UPAN, from the Mapuche language, and named from the astronomical objects in the Mapuche language. VLT operates at visible and infrared wavelengths.